and we are going to start things off on Seaside. Of course, it is 1-1 if you just joined us, so we will be seeing a map 4, potentially a map 5 as well. But guys in the chat, let it be known who you're taking for this one. We've already seen Mazer Gaming bounce back. Are you thinking Mazer? Are you thinking Project 7? Let us know, and we'll be sure to see whether you're right or not. And my goodness, a bloodbath through the middle. That's just hard to follow, but it splits evenly. A 2v2, and it looks like they're going straight for A.
And again, that's not something you would have saw at Vegas. Really, it was all down low pushes from both sides. That time, both teams fight over that mid control, and then they rotate on in. And see, Vivid knows that the opposing team in Project 7 is inside B. One tick almost there. Vicious with some nice shots. That cluster nade goes through as well. There we go. Destiny able to find another one. Project 7 should be able to get B. Maybe one last push on a Mazer to try to retake it. As we talked about, only a minute and 10 on that clock. That clock can run away very, very quickly if you are that attacking team.
Which certainly can. And once you get that second tick,
there we go. Able to retake it.
The lowest that they can do is get it back down to 2. It can't go any lower. They can't reset the whole thing. So it's really important just to cross over that threshold, if you like. But you need 3 of them. And right now, they've got 2 in the bag. Working on that third, though. We are going to see Vivid push in. He has the Sorg in hand, but he's faced by 3 opponents. And it's going to be a little bit too much for him.
So Noobs incoming. It looks like they're going to get this B zone. There we go. So what happens with that, they get a 60 extra seconds. Now, this is the tough one on a map like Seaside, because that church so close to the defensive spawn, it is difficult to first break into it, but then again hold it. As we'll see, maybe that momentum off that first push can get it, but it's just supreme agility alive right now. And well, when you're in this position, maybe you just try to find a couple of spawn kills. Not able to do so. Nice shots out of Atura, able to win that 1v1. Now a 1-life lead for Mazer.
Yeah, a huge 1v1 as well, because you let people kind of get behind enemy lines. It's very confusing, to say the least. And now Atura, what he has done, he's got a lot of information of where the players are pushing. It's down low, it's through the old zone, and Little Cells is making light work of those now, pushing through, holding that church. And as the time ticks down, it might not come down to 10 lives to 8 right now, favoring Mazer Gaming.
And there we go. Here's the switch up push out of Project 7. They're trying to push through this barrel side of the map. Maybe switch up the angles, but now Mazer, can they find all that information? Nice shots out of Noobs on Evasion and Little Cells. 7 versus 7 now. The lives so important. Nice little flank out of Vivid. Can he stay alive? He can't. Able to find 2. What a play out of him. And now he's going to push on up with that saw. Just try to stay alive inside barrel, though. It is one player still behind him, but he's just going for spawn kills. Able to catch them off guard. Can he find 4 in a row? He absolutely can.
Just like that, he makes it a technical 5v2.
Oh, 7 in a row.
This guy is on a streak and a half. Started 2 and 5. Changed things up. And like we said, sometimes we'll come down to those kills. And what I liked about that was when there was no respawning for the side of Project 7, they really kind of used that to their advantage. You know, they started challenging things in pairs, but it was Vivid.
I mean, he's a difference maker. That's 4 kills. When it was 7 to 7, he's able to pick up 4. Such a huge play out of him. And it really just starts in that courtyard. If he doesn't get those 2 kills, maybe Project 7 has an opportunity to cap or at least win by lives, by eliminating all the lives of Mazer. Instead, he's the difference maker.
Certainly is here as we get on board now with Mazer Gaming, already solidifying themselves a nice little round. Can they go back-to-back here on the offense? They're looking to go into B, and it's already going to be contested. And we're going to see first blood go to Destiny, however, answered back and forward. 2 split as we see Cells take the lead, and that's going to be a clean sweep here, as all 5 of those players will be coming off spawn now. This is a huge, huge start. Wow, that is a trophy system.
Yeah, that's really what we saw a ton of Vegas, was this lower site. Now, does the defensive team try to retake it? Looks like they will. Supreme agility. Jay Destiny try to get a win for this, but they have to go now. That last tick, loading on up. Destiny, Vicious, able to find a couple of kills. Hollow, still alive, though, causing as much mayhem as he can. But a nice retake, again, just wasting time. And if you could get pushed up towards the staircase, you'd be able to find some spawn kills. But Evasion was ready for it, able to find a couple.
Yeah, I thought the concussion might come into play there, but it doesn't find its way. And that 2 ticks will remain, of course, but a very important play, as you said here, coming in from Project 7, just to, you know, pause the attack here. Time ticks away. Agility and Noobs finding kills. And now this is where they can start to get aggressive and getting a spawn almost of Mazer Gaming.
Yeah, Supreme Agility does a nice job there. Just shoulders, Baxton on up. Not aware of his wide flank, though. There we go. Hollow takes a bit of a different angle, a bit of a wider angle on that roof. Able to find one, but still, watch that clock. 30 seconds left. Vivid in a nice spot under the window. Able to find one. Throws a cluster inside that church. And it looks like him and his team are on this B site. You saw a crash boost was popped right there from Project 7. As Mazer able to, I think, just get this B site, they will extend that time.
Nicely done here. And we're going to have to see Vivid just slow things down. We, of course, see a couple players still left with that Tactic 5 boost. Noobs and Dylan, of course, rocking it right now. But with a minute and 20 seconds, they need to defend a zero. Ticks have been taken away from that. And look at Agility here.
I love this play. Just go getting set up for these spawn kills. Yet you see he's behind three. No, there's a player behind them as well. Just trying to get set on up. Just trying to be a nuisance in the back of the enemy team. But if he stays here too long, he'll leave his team in a very bad position. But five players left. Seven versus five. As Noobs and Vicious able to find a couple of kills. Can he find any more? There we go. Supreme Agility. Doing his best to help him out now. Six versus five. This could be the difference maker in the game. Do you invest in any of your specialists if you are Mazer Gaming? It looked like he was trying to fly on in, maybe pop that grab slam, but he gets taken down. Now five versus four.
Yeah, the grab slam isn't going to come in, but are we going to see anything change? 4v3 right now. 3v3 as the lives go down. No respawning. It's do or die. Mate, your kills. Ooh. My goodness, what a kill that is. It's a 1v2. It's all up to Vivid.
And he has War Machine. Does he try to win this one? Instead, it looks like he's just going to try and use the saw. Now a one versus Supreme Agility. Trying to spot him. 17 seconds left. Supreme goes on top of the tank. I like that, but he backs on up. Trying to win the kill. There we go. Grab slam invested by Supreme Agility. And that's where you question Vicious right there. Or sorry, Vivid right there. If he invests in the War Machine, he might win that round. And instead of it being tied 1-1, they're up 2-0.
Yeah. I mean, you think about that War Machine and, you know, you think how much of an impact can a specialist make. If you can win the game with it.
Win a round.
Yeah, win the round with it, go for it. But I will say, a bit of an awkward position. Yep. With him on that top of that tank, you know, there was no kind of direct impact he could get. But the grab slam, on the other hand,
beautiful.
I like what he was doing there. You know, getting that height elevation, securing the round. Now 1-1, all tied up as we see Noobs. And it's a very beautiful Maddox. Another push towards B, looking for the outskirts here.
See, big 1v1 going down in the middle. Hollow versus Destiny. As Vicious is able to find one, and now he has help from top middle, and there we go. They're going to explode towards this B site, but Vivid just hits him in the back, and what a game from Vivid right now. He's at 21-11 with this SOG, having such an impact on the team, plus able to defend so well. Mazer now in a great position, able to bring out that War Machine. Here we go. But there's a difference. The flat jacket is ready, still able to find two. And now they have a 5-kill lead, does Mazer.
Yeah, and sometimes when you get that lead, you can really be aggressive with it and put the pressure on. Still, War Machine has a couple shots as well. What could he do with it? Just the one left as the cluster grenade sets himself up nicely to just to return to B. But all this time is just ticking away. 5-kill lead, 2 zones to the hand, and 40 seconds left on the clock. This is looking fantastic for Mazer.
Now, what does Project 7 do? Do they try to go for this A site? It looks like they're actually going all the way around towards B, maybe trying to set up a pinch. You see Supreme Agility and Noobs. There's only 28 seconds left. They have to wait for their teammates. But look, on the other side of the map, Mazer have just gone to the spawn of their team. They have to do something. They have to do it now. It looks like they are finally able to get into that B site. Maybe they can get some control.
They need to
win
the
1v1s. But it took them to go all the way around the map.
Yeah, it took so much time, and the teammates weren't able to pick up the kills. You saw the plan. You saw what they were trying to do here, but it doesn't look like they're even going to get a tick of either zone right now with 15 seconds left. This has been well played from Mazer, as we see one player, that being Atora, just tucked away in a nice nook and cranny there, and he's going to find himself another round on the board. Just look at the kills as well. 21 lives still available for Mazer Gaming, only 6 for Project 7. That really tells a story.
And again, if you don't get that first point, if you're the offensive team, that clock runs down so fast.
Oh, yeah.
After their second push, there was about 25 seconds left, and it forced two players to go all the way around through barrel. And Mazer Gaming was ready for it. Vivid having a huge game right now with that SOG. I believe he was somewhere around 25-12 at one point. And now you're in desperation mode if you're Project 7. It's all about investing in these specialists. You have the War Machine, you have Tempest, you have Annihilator. You have all the big ones if you're them. You're pretty happy you're in a solid spot. But can they use them effectively? Dylan, right now at 8-17, not having the best map.
Incredible stuff so far here. Let's see if this is going to be the last round of control. Or are we going to see this pushed, of course, to one more? Who's going to win the initials? That's the question. It's going to come in. Amazer Gaming looking strong. Three go down. Noobs and Dylan there, the only ones alive for a second. But as B starts to go away, this round alone, they've got more ticks than the previous.
Yeah, and look at Evasion. Look at the position he's in. Plus, that Lightning Strike is being called in. He was trying to get away from it. Is Atura able to find a couple? He's on a seven spree, has the drone squad as well. Gosh, I can't lie to you. Dark Matter is it's pretty. It's a scary weapon when those spikes start to grow from the side.
You start to think, you know, when you see those spikes, you're feeling yourself. You think, hang on, I'm doing well. Look at me go.
Yeah.
I'm feeling myself right now. And Atura with 2 HP. Ambitiously just dives on up, and with not a care in the world, here comes the drone squad.
It sounded like that War Machine was popped as well from Destiny, so no War Machine for them. Dylan Rex, he does have the Annihilator out. 4 shots left, took down his teammate on accident. But now if you're Maisie, maybe you just wait this one out. Why give him any kills? And they do just that. So now it's on Vicious. He has to be the playmaker here with that Tempest. They're down by 9 lives, plus the drone squad's out as well. This is going to be a very tough round for Project 7 to win, but if they're able to do it, it's looking good for round 5.
Trying to do the bait and switch up top here. We are going to see, oh my goodness, a grab slam onto the teammate there. Not going to help anywhere. 2 players go down. Atura still has the Hellstorm available, but it is all about getting into this zone right now, making a mark, and that could be the opening from Vicious.
I love that awareness as well, but Hollow still able to get the best of him. Hollow now trying to stay alive up top Church. You still have an 8-kill lead with about 60 seconds left. If I'm Mazer, I'm just playing kills. Don't even worry about the point right now. Atura, it looks like he just invested in the Hellstorm as well. So they're going all for this one. Is Vivid able to find 2? He's at 30-15, plus little cells with that Annihilator. He gets traded out. So Project 7, they're doing a pretty good job, but now it's on Vicious. Vicious has to be the playmaker with this Tempest to get them off. Again, they're down by 8 kills right now. How many can he get with this Tempest?
Well, they can stay inside the zone. They don't have to push out. Yeah, they don't have to be aggressive.
They just wait. There's still 50 seconds left.
This may be a bit of a waiting game right now. We've seen 2 players push around the flank, and that's why Vicious is edging his way off as well. Tries for a little bit of a quick scope onto him. Doesn't connect there, but he's going to find Evasion secondly. Take him down as well. But after tagging up one, Hollow does find the kill. Hollow actually might be able to stand up. He doesn't. Supreme Agility is going to take him down, but now a 9v5 as the time ticks away.
And again, you have to invest in this tag 5 boost because you're down in numbers. You have to win this round to extend the game. Atura, he pops, is able to find a couple of kills. Evasion, now it's his turn. 6 versus 3. Project 7 still alive in this one. Can they clutch this on up? Can they take this to a round number 5? Vicious, able to win 1. Can he find the second? No. But the cluster is there. Those things give me nightmares, Phil.
The time. The time is ticking.
4 seconds left, but it's just 1 player left. Mazer Gaming, they played it very, very well. A lot of teamwork. They had to invest in a lot. 3 streaks.
Yeah.
A lot of specialists. And that's what we talked about, how strong it is to defend that Church side. But still, with all that utility, they're able to win this game 3-1.
The Mazer Gaming fans and the Mazer Gaming love is showing right now. And for a second, I thought a huge mistake was about to go in there with the time ticking down, but they just timed it perfectly as they slid on in pretty much a 3v1 and putting the pressure on the opposition there and securing not only the round, but the map as well. So 2-1 now in favor of Mazer Gaming on our first semifinal, the CWL 2K. But so far, so good. We've got some good action, and we're going to be heading into another hardpoint.